मेरा नाम दयाचंद है जी। मैंने 2008 से काम शुरू किया। द्वारका में पहले यूनिवर्सिटी थी, पार्ट टाइम में मैं आता था, और उसके बाद 2012 में कश्मीरी गेट कैंपस बनना शुरू हुआ। यहाँ पे हमने ये देखा कि यहाँ पे जंगल झाड़ काफ़ी था, आदमी का आना भी बड़ा मुश्किल था। यहाँ पे थोड़ा बहुत बड़ा जंगल था यहाँ।
जुलाई 2010 में हमें ये कश्मीरी गेट कैंपस हैंड ओवर हुआ था। ये हेरिटेज स्टेज था, हेरिटेज बिल्डिंग थे, तो इसको हम वॉल वगैरह जैसे रूफ वगैरह ये तोड़ नहीं सकते थे, तो हमें खाली इसे अंदर अंदर से रेनोवेट करना होता था। जब मैं फर्स्ट टाइम आया था तो ये मुगल स्टोन देख के बड़ा अट्रैक्टिव हुआ था कि अच्छा इस तरह का है।
The mandate that was given to us in 2008 was somewhat modest. You know, my sense is that all that the government at that point in time expected us to do was to cater to the spillover from the undergraduate humanities and social sciences colleges courses of Delhi University, and to create opportunities for such students who do not get into universities like Delhi University to study here. So we thought of two, three major things. One is that we should have a unitary university which combines both undergraduate and postgraduate programs and research programs, like the way most universities should be. And second, we thought that the most of our programs, the major thrust of our programs, should be on interdisciplinary areas. We had an advantage that this was in Delhi. There was a locational advantage, so it was easy to get good faculty to come here. So therefore, while we created the shell of an idea of a program, the force that actually gave life to these programs were the faculty.
AUD was an extremely interesting space in those early days because we were it was like starting on a clean slate, and we were learning to create an institution from scratch. It was a very small team. All of us could fit into one room with some space to spare.
So 2008, when the university began, there was not any building, no any room in that sense. So I mean, we begin with one room in University of Delhi, where Professor Menon has an office in this Department of Education, and also at the same time, Professor Menon, in his own residence, made one room, one of the room, converted into a working office of the university, and that's how we began to work there itself, in his own home, in his own quarters, in that sense, in one of the small room.
Well, the university started in 2008. It started as a kind of an experiment. As you know, the university was mandated to promote teaching and research in social science and humanities. So in a sense, it was one of a kind.
I think one of the significant challenges for social sciences is that in the current reality, it is assumed that technology will solve all the problems. Unfortunately, that's a very partial and limited perspective of engaging with social issues. And unless social sciences, you know, step forward and go beyond being commentators and critics, we'll never be able to address issues holistically.
Having done a master's in the same field from Ambedkar, and in the year 2016 I started my course, and I've just recently in the month of April completed my course successfully in management, along with a byproduct that is food mystery. We provide breakfast to college students. 88% of young adults, that is the category that we are serving, don't consume breakfast on a regular basis, and that was a striking figure for us. That is when food mystery happened, and right from December we've been doing this project and thinking of going ahead.
So currently I'm employed as fellow in action research at Center for Development Practice at Ambedkar University, Delhi, and I did my master's in psychology from AUD and started in 2010. And after post my master's, I did MPhil in development practice from the same university. And uske baad se, throughout my life, I've been very passionate about the community-based work. And AUD ne mujhe wo opportunity bhi diya to learn the knowledge for working with the community, and also at the same time gave a proper ground to start working with the community. So with the same ideology, we started a post my MPhil. We started a project called Kinare in Center for Development Practice. जिसमें हमने यमुना पुष्टा पे जो फार्मर्स दिल्ली में काम करते हैं उनके साथ हमने थोड़ा बहुत काम करना शुरू किया। सो वी अप्रोच इंक्यूबेशन सेंटर और हमने सोचा कि हम एक बार इनसे बात करते हैं। एंड इंक्यूबेशन सेंटर कम्प्लीटली सपोर्टेड द थिंग एंड वी लॉन्च द कंपनी कॉल्ड अर्बन क्यारी अंडर द लार्ज अम्ब्रेला ऑफ प्रोजेक्ट किनारे। एंड नाउ फ्रॉम विद दिस कंपनी फार्मर्स आर गेटिंग एन अपॉर्चुनिटी फॉर द इक्वल फॉर ऑल्टरनेटिव लाइवलीहुड एंड दे आर डूइंग फार्मिंग ऑन द रूफटॉप्स ऑफ दिल्ली।
In 2014, I joined the Ambedkar University and I joined initially the School of Design, where I think it's again a unique experiment which is happening, which is a master's level program in social design. And then onwards, the university, I think, also entrusted me with this responsibility that they would like to start an incubation center for entrepreneurship within the university, and given my background, I think I brought in a certain way of looking at this, and I think how I see this initiative right now, which is from the incubation center, is that how do you help young people translate their ideas into actions? How do you make them realize that? What we are doing is helping people stand on their own, create enterprises, and especially create enterprises which have a role in terms of transforming society.
जब मैं AUD में आया था तो एक लर्निंग एक सीखने के लिए आया था तो उसमें सीखना बहुत सारा हुआ मेरे साथ। मेरी लर्निंग जो है वो असली लर्निंग सिर्फ क्लास रूम स्ट्रक्चर के अंदर ना होने के बजाय जो हमारे अलग डिपार्टमेंट के साथ जो एक जो बच्चे थे जब हम डिस्कशंस करते थे ओपन में उससे ज़्यादा हुई। प्लस जो टीचर्स का जो यहाँ पे किसी भी टाइम आप जब उन्हें मेल लिखो आप कभी फंसे हुए हो तो वो एक अच्छी चीज़ थी कि आप और टीचर के बीच में ऐसी कोई हायरार्की नहीं है कि आप बात नहीं कर सकते उनसे या वो एक्सेसिबल नहीं है। आप उनसे बात कर सकते हो, आप मेल लिख सकते हो, आप उनसे जाके कभी भी बात कर सकते हो अपनी दिक्कतों के बारे में। तो अच्छी चीज़ ये थी जो मुझे लगता है कि एक AUD को और मेरे खुद की एक लर्निंग को एक अलग एक्सपीरियंस देती है।
सो दिस वॉज अ वेरी डिफरेंट यूनिवर्सिटी। आई फाउंड दैट इट वॉज ऑल्सो सीइंग फिल्म एज एन आर्टिस्टिक प्रैक्टिस बट ऑल्सो वॉन्टेड टू सी हाउ इट्स सोशली रेलिवेंट। सो द फैक्ट दैट कोर्सेज वर मेड विद अ सॉर्ट ऑफ न्यू थॉट विद अ कंटेम्पररी नीड, सो इट सीम लाइक यूनिवर्सिटी इज नॉट क्रिएटिंग बुकिश स्कॉलिस्टिक वर्क। इट वॉज मोर लाइक यूनिवर्सिटी वॉन्ट्स टू अंडरस्टैंड ह्यूमन एस्पिरेशन, ह्यूमन प्रैक्टिस, ह्यूमन वैल्यूज। So coming from that theater film background, it seemed like a place to go, to learn, to talk, to interact.
Initially, the way we imagined this entire school, we thought that it would be a space where multiple disciplines of art could interact with each other. You know, that was the fundamental idea when in 2011-12 we started this program. We all were trained in interdisciplinary disciplines. I must have joined as an assistant professor, but then we did not have any problem in accessing the vice chancellor. You know, you have an idea, you can just shoot it. AUD in spirit, it talks about being non-hierarchical. It is non-hierarchical. It's open to new ideas.
Mera naam Sangeeta hai aur maine abhi apni masters khatam kari hai. Ambedkar aane ke baad mujhe apni life mein bahut zyada changes mile. मैंने सबसे पहले अपना काम CCK के साथ स्टार्ट किया तो मेरे एक दोस्त ने मनोज ने मुझे बताया CCK के बारे में। तो वहाँ मुझे उनका काम बड़ा अच्छा लगा, वो डॉक्यूमेंट्री करते हैं और डिफरेंट कम्युनिटीज़ को पढ़ते हैं। तो मैं वहाँ से मैंने थोड़ा सा डॉक्यूमेंट्री उनके साथ किया, दो प्रोजेक्ट्स हमने किए थे। मतलब मेरी जो कम्युनिटी है तो मैं पॉटर्स कम्युनिटी से बिलोंग करती हूँ तो क्यों ना मैं अपनी कम्युनिटी के ऊपर ही करूँ। तो मैं अपने गाँव गई, वहाँ से मुझे थोड़ा बहुत आइडिया लगा कि हाँ मैं कर सकती हूँ। तो मतलब मुझे ऐसा लगा कि अंबेडकर यूनिवर्सिटी ने मुझे इसी तरह का कंट्रीब्यूशन देने के लिए आई गेस मजबूर किया है, क्योंकि यहाँ इतनी सारी अपॉर्चुनिटीज़ हैं, यहाँ इतने सारे आपको मतलब स्पेसेस मिलेंगे। मैं अभी थोड़े दिन पहले एक बच्चा अपना वो उसने मुझे बोला कि अंबेडकर की वो करा दो आप थोड़ा कि क्या है अंबेडकर में। तो मैं उसको CCK के पास लेकर गई, मैंने कहा ये सबसे बेस्ट ऑफिस है यहाँ का, तो अगर तुम आओगे तो इसको एक्सप्लोर ज़रूर करना, यहाँ से यू कैन यू नो सी आई मीन गेट्स विल बी ओपन फॉर यू। तो अम्बेडकर यूनिवर्सिटी वॉज आई मीन सच अ प्लेस एंड आई रियली वॉन्ट टू कम बैक हियर अगेन।
माई अंडरस्टैंडिंग इज दैट इन द यूनिवर्सिटी टू बिलीव दैट एहसास इज अ प्लेस फॉर पीपल टू गो विद देयर कंक्लूजंस, दे कैन रीलुक एट देयर सेल्फ what is required, and I would say to a large extent what Ambedkar University teachers are again uniquely doing is they are trying to listen to students. Yeah, this is something which I would really like to commend about my colleagues. It is rare that a student will come and say that there was not a single teacher to whom I could go. So they can go to teachers, they talk about their inner life to teachers, and this is a link that I wish in the future can be strengthened even more.
We receive the land for developing our campus, which is approximately 40 acres. But adjoining that 40-acre area, there is this 60 acres of wetland, which we have committed to DDA that we will help restore. So that is how the Center for Urban Ecology and Sustainability was born. There will be parts that are accessible to public. You know, they can come for their walks, they can see the birds, they can enjoy nature. Particularly in that area, high density population, high population density in Mukherjee Nagar, you have Gandhi Vihar, these are very densely populated sort of neighborhoods, and it will add a lot of value to the neighborhood as well. On the AUD side, what we are imagining is this will be sort of an extension of the campus community, and students can walk across into this 60 acres. This is 60 acres approximately, campus is 40. So students will have access to this area. Some researchers can do field experiments, they can study birds.
Center for Early Childhood Education and Development is one of the first centers that was started in AUD, and so we are nearly 9 years this year. For the past 8 years, our contributions have been very significant. So policy being implemented means a lot of states have come to us to ask for support as to how do we evolve this kind of a field, how do we bring the policy into practice. So we have been helping the states, and that's where I think our interface with government and particular Anganwadis is very strong, because you know we are working with 5 states, giving technical support to the states to translate the policy into practice by helping them to develop curriculum, training and things like that.
When I say disability studies, I try to say that disability is knowledge, it's epistemology. You know, where we gain from disability, it's not as if we're going to lose, we gain from society disability. And I also feel that, you know, somewhere we also produce knowledge through disability. When I joined AUD in 2015, we were also trying to, you know, think about, and Professor Menon mentioned that we must have a corpus, you know, corpus of knowledge. When I was an adjunct, I started an undergraduate course which is called Understanding Disability Through Popular Narrative, and basically we use cinema. So we were trying to use cinema to make them understand what disability is, and we were trying to compare the Bollywood movies and the Hollywood movies and how disability is, you know, portrayed in cinema, and how we understand disability through that.
What we have realized over the years is that we are the only university in this city which is actually the city's university. 2009-10, we had about 100 students. Now we are about 2,500, right? And we are projected to grow by another 5 times in 6-7 years. So from about 2,500 now, we are expected to grow to about 12 to 14,000 students in 2023-24. We started with one campus, but we got a new campus in Karampura in 2016, another campus in Lodhi Road in 2017. So now currently we have 3 campuses, right? And we have also got land from the government in 2 places, and our new permanent campuses would also be ready by the year 2023.
So I imagine that in the next few years we will be a big hub for the field of early childhood education, where we are expecting that I would feel there would be a lot of collaborations and networks across, starting from AUD to international and international collaborations, where we would want to be a kind, build a presence in the South Asian region as a very important hub for early childhood education. So we imagine that we will be moving towards that.
Other thing is the scale at which we will, and the space at which we'll grow, is going to be a very, very significant challenge. So right now we are about 2,500 students, and we expect to grow up to about 15,000 students. And that's going to be another organizational, governance, and administrative challenge. And that's something that we'll have to certainly gear up to.
The next stage in this university's life will also be with equal affection and care, will be nurtured by a new set of leadership, a new kind of leadership, which should probably have a sort of new styles, but at the same time will hold on to the core principles, the core values, the core elements of the AUD's vision. That I hope will happen, and I think it will happen, because there is already a second line of leadership in this university. There is already a well coordinated teamwork which ensures development of all aspects of nurturance of all aspects of this university.
This structuring has changed when I joined. Now there are many ramps which are there now, but we still need a lot of work because it's an old campus, and I'm hoping that all our campuses will be disabled friendly and we can get disabled students. That's more important, because you know that's my dream, I think.
Our idea is that the students who will be passing out, the kind of students we are creating, they will contribute in two very significant ways. First is that we are trying to create a community of social scientists, people who would have an inclination as a social scientist, who would think like a social scientist, which means that they will scrutinize the world, the society, the institutions, the world around them.